Father, we thank you for today. Thank you that in spite of the rain, we get the privilege of seeing these two commit their lives to you through this public display of baptism. Lord, we're excited about what this means moving forward, knowing that you got all of us on a journey, and this is the next step in Chris and Kathryn's. We ask that you'll be glorified as we step into this special moment, and we pray in the name of Jesus that years from now, stories will be told about the faithfulness of these two, and it'll encourage the hearts of those who hear it. And we pray this in Jesus' name, and all those who agree said amen.
Amen.
All right, man, this is awesome. I'm looking around and seeing all these people. This is in there too. This is great, y'all. Well, hey, I want to present to you Chris and Kathryn Ledé. I'm going to share a little bit of both of their stories and how they ended up in this particular situation. But I'll start with Chris. So Chris and Kathryn, their stories are going to overlap, but they are both from Louisiana, Southeast Louisiana to be exact.
Woo.
Raging Cajun country. That's Woo. What they do. They both grew up in a faith tradition in which the truths of God were part of their upbringing. This young man, I wasn't aware, was even a youth minister in a season. So, Hub Ministries. I hear someone knocking on the door.
Already has.
Okay, there we go. There we go. Well, the beauty of Chris's story is that after he graduated from college, the Lord led him and Kathryn as newlyweds here in Houston, and a separation of sorts started to happen with the foundation of faith that was laid for him. For many years, Team Ledé has not had the benefit of walking through the reality of being able to have kids. And so early on in their marriage, they were challenged with the notion they might not be able to have a family on their own. Well, that began some rumbling as it relates to their faith foundation, to the point that they slowly just became more distant from their church. Well, fast forward, they're in the process of some IVF treatments. They're getting ready to take the last one. And right before that, they find out they're pregnant. This was a praise because for so long, they didn't know that they could have kids. They find out they're pregnant with little Drew. And a couple weeks into that pregnancy, they get word that he would probably not live very long if he was not stillborn. Praise be to God, that's not what happened. He was born healthy. Healthy as a whip. And because of that testimony, that's exactly what God used to bring Chris to the point of realizing in the same way, and these are Chris's words, not mine, in the same way that God healed that little boy in her womb, he also reconciled his relationship with God through that. Mm. Fast forward. They're still in this place of wanting to expand their family. And so after realizing that they were continuing to walk through some of the challenges of having kids naturally, adoption knocks on their door. They're preparing to have a little boy enter their home. And within 24 hours, that completely changed to a little girl was entering their home. And that little girl, Juliet, is now part of their family. And so now, yeah. And so now they have a son and a daughter. And God has used those challenges to bring Chris to the place of acknowledging his need to publicly profess his faith in Jesus, but also to give thanks to the Lord for what he's done. And in many respects, this is a thank you. And so your being here as well is an encouragement to him. And so Chris, I'm sure I speak for all these men and women, these boys and girls, when I say we're proud of you, we're excited about this next step of your journey. And we are elated about what this means for you guys joining our church. And so you'll cross your arms, my friend. On your profession of faith, Chris, it is indeed my privilege to baptize you this afternoon in the name of God the Father, in the name of his Son, Jesus the Christ, and in the name of the Holy Spirit who empowers for life and godliness. Buried with Christ in baptism. Get him in, get him in. Thank you. Well, friends, this is Kathryn. Kathryn had the privilege also of growing up in a home where matters of faith were a part of what they did. And in ninth grade, she went on a mission trip that changed her life and helped her understand that God was calling her to a life of fruitfulness in the way of serving Him. She also had the privilege of going off to college, meeting this guy. They got married, moved here to Houston, and part of Kathryn's story takes a different turn than Chris's here. Kathryn has, for many years, had to walk through depression. And God has used that in a way that has brought her a hope in God that, quite honestly, without those challenges, she probably wouldn't be here today. At one point, the darkness of the depression became so deep that Chris lovingly had to take his bride to a facility and have her admitted. Through all of this, though, their story is one of a roller coaster. Through all of this, God has faithfully shown Himself, and His love for her is even more visible now because of what she has come through. And so, very simply put, Kathryn is here today to honor the foundation that was laid with her parents, but to also say, thank you, Mom and Dad, I am now taking the reins, and I'm gonna continue to push this ball down the field. And so, Kathryn, my sister, it is indeed a privilege to baptize you here with your church family and your husband. And so, on your profession of faith, it is indeed my privilege and my honor to baptize you this afternoon in the name of God the Father, who loves you immensely, in the name of Jesus Christ, who died that you might live, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, who empowers for life and godliness. Buried with Christ in baptism. Raised to walk in newness of life. Yes! Absolutely, absolutely. Well, friends, this is a picture of what it means to be the body. And I just want to say thank you all for being here to support them. I told Chris earlier, they are going to look back at this day and they are going to have such fond memories because you all are the hands and feet of Jesus in the way of loving them through this. So thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting them through this. And if you need to get baptized, please contact me at sienna@ucspiritual.org. No, this has been a great time, and thank you again for being here. So I am now going to ask you all to do me one favor. Let's pray together. And by praying together, I'm going to ask you to repeat after me. And we're just going to give God thanks for this day and this moment. So let's pray together. Lord God.
Lord God. You're beautiful.
You're beautiful.
And we thank you.
For Chris and Kathryn.
May these baptisms.
Bring you honor and glory.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, clap it up, y'all. Clap it up. Clap it up.